Last 24-hour period, we had 118,000 tests, which is increasingly a good number, and 882 cases of community transmission. Two people lost their lives overnight, and we extend our condolences to their families, a male in their 60s, a male in their 90s, both with underlying health conditions, and both with just one dose of the vaccine. 80% of our cases continue to be in Western and Southwestern Sydney, at least. Pleasingly, there's already been discussion with the university sector, so no New South Wales students will be disadvantaged. It means the marking period and adjusting of scores won't happen till mid-January, but the university sector is appreciative of that and can accommodate that, which is good. Face-to-face learning will commence from October the 25th. It'll be staggered with kindy and year one starting, and then successively, progressively other years, and I'll ask Minister Mitchell to outline those details. We're also asking for everybody that works on a school campus, whether it's a teacher or school staff member, to be vaccinated by the November the 8th. Education has already done surveys and a large proportion of teachers are already vaccinated, but we are calling out for anybody, to any teacher who's not vaccinated, to get vaccinated, and we'll be supporting them and assisting them by having a special day for teachers on the 6th of September and a special week for teachers to make sure that any teachers or staff who will be going back to campus with school children are vaccinated at least before the 8th of November. But we're so pleased that there seems to be a high rate of vaccination amongst teachers already. Can I also stress that if there's any area of New South Wales which comes out of lockdown before October 25, that those children will automatically go back to school. So if health decides that any part of New South Wales is coming out of lockdown before the 25th of October date, well, that will obviously mean that schools can go back to face-to-face learning, as the regions had for a long time and as parts of Greater Sydney may have as well. So there are opportunities for school to go back earlier if that community is out of lockdown. Pleasingly, I note the federal government has announced that 12 to 15 year olds will start having access to vaccines, and we assume that will be done in September, so that is also a pleasing development to give everybody that extra degree of comfort. And we're really looking forward to transitioning children back to face-to-face learning. We know what a difficult period of time this is, and we thank everybody, including all the community groups and stakeholders who've been working with education and health to ensure the safety of our students, teaching staff and parents during this difficult time.